Hey guys, it's Very Slicks. Thanks for coming back to our channel. Today we're gonna be talking about Daisy Finks. Let's get started.
Let's get started.
When Daisy was just 3 years old, her mother was murdered by three white men. Her mother's death forced Daisy to confront racist man, dedicate her life to racial equality. At just 15, Daisy met her future husband, and together they traveled through the South, eventually settling in Little Fort, Arkansas. There she and her husband started the Arkansas Legal League, which was the only African-American newspaper dedicated solely to the civil rights movement. Daisy served as president of the Arkansas chapter of the AFR-SCP. In 1954, when the Supreme Court ruled that segregating schools was unconstitutional, Daisy began gathering African-American students to enroll into white schools. In 1957, when the AFR-SCP began to focus the efforts onto schools in Arkansas, Daisy organized the Little Rock Nine. This group consisted of 9 black students that were to integrate into Central High School. Daisy drove the students to school to ensure their safety.
That's pretty cool.
With the success of the Little Rock Nine, Daisy continued to work to improve the status of African American students.
This work also unfortunately caused Daisy and her family to become targets of threats. This intimidation forced the Bates family to stop printing their newspaper.
That's not really cool.
In 1962, her memoir, The Long Shadow of the Little Rock, would go on to win an American Book Award.
Daisy died November 4, 1999. Because of her dedication to the state of Arkansas, they declared the third Monday of February
Daisy Gaston Bates Day.
She was also awarded the Medal of Freedom in 1999 posthumously.
That means she won after she died.
Thanks for explaining that, Grayson.
That's it for today. Join us tomorrow
for another Black History Fact.
Bye! Bum, 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 bum